The worst thing for creative people is to not be creative because they just die. And it because it's like maybe you're a tree with a few major branches, you know? That's your personality. So if you're extroverted, man, you can't be cut off from people because you just wither. And if you're agreeable, you have to be in an intimate relationship or you die, you know? And if you're conscientious, man, and you're unemployed, you're just going to eat yourself up because you have to have a duty and you have to carry a load because you just can't stand it otherwise. And open people have to be creative. They have to be because otherwise they die. They don't have any vitality. And so they're cursed with the necessity of putting a foot out into the unknown and making sense of it. And then they're also cursed with the necessity of trying to make a living while they're doing that, which they can't because you can't. It's almost impossible to monetize creative action, as many of you who are creative will no doubt find out. It's very, very frustrating. It's not that creative action is without value, right? Because the creative people are entrepreneurs and the creative people revitalize cities and the creative people make things magnificent and beautiful. You think about what's happened in Europe over the last 1,000 years, say 2,000 years, this amazing, unbelievable collaboration to make things so beautiful that they're jaw-dropping when you walk into them. And you think about the economic value of that, right? I mean, I think it's either France or Spain that's the most visited country in the world. It's one of those two. I think there's more tourists in France than there are people most of the time. And part of the reason for that is it's just so damn beautiful. You just can't stand it. And you think, what's the economic value of that? It's absolutely incalculable. And what's interesting, too, is that you build that beauty in, and then the farther away you get from it in time, the more valuable it becomes, right? Instead of decaying, it has exactly the opposite effect. Its value magnifies. And one of the things that I'm deeply ashamed of as a Canadian is that our sense of beauty is so underdeveloped. We're so primitive. It's not even primitive. That's the wrong word because, you know, I don't know what it is. It's second rate. It's second rate at least. It's terror too because people are afraid of beauty. But the idea that art is... The conservatives really have a problem with this in particular because conservative people tend not to be that creative. And it's a mystery by temperament. It's a mystery to me because they should be concerned with economic development and beauty is so unbelievably crucial to economic development that it just yells out at you, you know? So anyway, so that's what artists are doing. And so one of the things I would say is buy a damn piece of art, you know? Find one that really speaks to you and buy a piece of art because you invite that into your life and it's a... Look out if you do it, if it's a real piece of art, because you'll also get a little introduction to the artist, and then that'll seep into your life, and that'll change things like mad. But it's unbelievably worth it, because it opens your eyes to the domain of the transcendent. That's the right way of thinking about it. A real piece of art is a window into the transcendent. That's what it is. And you need that in your life, because you're finite and limited and bounded, right, by your ignorance and your lack of knowing. And unless you can make a connection to the transcendent, then you don't have the strength to prevail. You look at these magnificent cathedrals that our civilization built over the centuries. You know, some of those, they're still building the Sagrada Familia in Barcelona, right? And it's an amazing building. I think it's going to take them like 300 years to build that. You know, people in the Middle Ages, they'd start building a cathedral and they think, we'll be done this in 300 years. You know, imagine the vision that it took to invest in something like that. We look at quarterly reports. We can't think 300 years into the future to build something of that kind of remarkable, what? Those cathedrals are so, they're perfect. They're trees first, right? They're a forest, right? The Gothic cathedrals, they're a forest. And the sun is shining through the branches. That's the stained glass. And they're the perfect balance of light and structure because... They're representing something about the proper structure of being, which is something like the proper balance between light and structure. And they represent like the sacred tragedy of mankind. That's why they're in the shape of a cross. And they're open to the sky. That's why they have a dome. And they're full of gold.